Hello and welcome. You're watching ongoing coverage of the big news story that Times Now broke at 4:30 this evening. It's a story that has set the national agenda. It's a story in which a dramatic disclosure behind the scenes move led by Sri Sri Ravi Shankar to resolve the Babri Masjid Ram Mandir dispute. At 4:30 p.m. this evening, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar disclosed that on October 6, a number of key stakeholders central to the dispute met him in his ashram to discuss a way forward. Those are the pictures of that meeting, ladies and gentlemen. Sri Sri told me that the initiative was blessed by the Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath of Uttar Pradesh, and that stakeholders, most of them who are extremely, extremely germane to the entire Babri Masjid Ram Mandir Janambhoomi dispute, were there, and that they are serious and positive about resolving this out of court through consensus and not through court edict, because they believe that any judgment that comes through might be weighing too much in favor of one or the other party, leading to, of course, a deepening of fault lines, communal fault lines in this country, and also harboring in people, or leading to the harboring in people of resentment, the seeds of resentment, which will only harm the idea and unity of India. Here is the interaction which has set the news agenda. Sri Sri ji, thank you for speaking to Times Now. There is a growing appreciation among some sections, sir, of Hindus and Muslims, even the judiciary. In fact, even in some quarters of government and political opinion, political parties, for resolving the Ram Mandir dispute through consensus. Do you welcome this, sir? Do you think that this is the way forward? You've been interlocuting. Do you think this is the way forward?
I think the second option is what I would prefer, and I have always been advocating for that. This is an opportunity for community to show their magnanimity and come closer to each other. Court settlement, whatever the court order, we miss this opportunity if we wait for the court order.
Okay, but we of course need credible mediators, and mediators who of course the stakeholders can trust. Now, you're a credible mediator because you're apolitical, essentially. You don't belong to a political party, and you're not one of the original plaintiffs, respondents, or petitioners. So you have emerged as the most likely candidate. How open are you per se to an idea such as this that has been expressed really by the former Chief Justice, and also, of course, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, how open have those you've been talking to been with you?
I'm all willing to do in this regard. Whenever the interested parties approach me, I'm willing to sit with them.
Well, you have been engaging the stakeholders actively, sir. Sri Sri Sahib, Guruji, you have been talking to them. There is, of course, evidence of that. How is that engagement process been going?
I cannot say, because we have been trying this for a long time. So I have always appealed to both the communities to come closer and close the matter. That's all I can say. But if there is any response from me from any other side, then I'll take it up.
Now, there was an October 6 meeting when you spoke to the stakeholders. Did they seem to appreciate the necessity of consensus? Were they positive, Sri Sri?
I see there is a positivity. There is willingness now.
Willingness, yeah. And there's positivity. So you got that from the stakeholders. Now, this is very, very important, because there was an October 6 meeting. And in that October 6 meeting, of course, the developments to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, who has emerged as this fulcrum of interlocution, was positive. What do you think is bringing about this acceptance of consensus over a court resolution, sir, or a court verdict in resolving the Ram Mandir dispute, Sri Sri Ji?
I think it's too long. People have realized that we have to move on, we have to come closer, and there are many other issues to worry about it. So we should resolve this. This is, I think, general feeling among all, both the communities.
Well, let me tell you that both sides, and I've been speaking to both sides off and on, our reporters have been speaking to both sides off and on, barring a few elements who are quite radical on both sides, who are really on the fringe. I can tell you that the idea of a resolution through consensus is very appealing to both of them, because both these sides believe that this issue has now become central to what really is the idea of India. Sri Sri Ji.
I feel it's very important, you know. It was actually, it's too long, something is brewing like this for a very long time. Now that thing, people should, they are ready, I feel they are ready to do it now. I think.
Well, how hopeful are you, Sri Sri Ji, about a breakthrough? And how open were the stakeholders to settling the dispute through talks? Because this is something, you know, both sides have a very different take on it. And I'm going to say this very openly. The Muslim community says that we are the younger brothers in this particular dispute. And the Hindus are the older brothers and they need to be more magnanimous. But how hopeful are you, CCG, about a breakthrough? And when you spoke to them, how open were these stakeholders of an immediate conclusion to this?
Keep our fingers crossed. I wish it will get resolved sooner.
Resolved sooner. So you're very positive. You're positive of a resolution through consensus before the courts pronounce a verdict. Now that is good news. That is very good news, because if that is indeed the case, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji, you would have done a national service, sir. You would have done a national service.
You know, when it comes to magnanimity, it's, both sides have to be magnanimous. And I think they both, there are people who are magnanimous on both sides, and there are people who are not so magnanimous on both sides. So I think now things are changing. I'm sure people would like to come together with a goodwill and good celebration in this respect.
So, Shishi Ji, you're positive of a resolution, even though there might be certain differences of opinion, you're essentially positive.
As I said, I will keep my fingers crossed and I wish it gets resolved very soon.
Well, I can understand why you don't want to give away much, because this is very sensitive, and I can tell you, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji, that you are doing a yeoman service to this nation, because if this matter is not resolved through consensus, and I think the Chief Justice, the Supreme Court is well aware that there could be some amount of resentment on the outside if they feel that the courts have not been favorable to both sides or have favored one over the other. So, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, thank you very much for speaking to me here. You're a spiritual guru, you're a man of God, you're also an individual who first puts humanity. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is speaking to me at 4:30 this evening, setting the stage for a great debate that's been ensuing all through the evening. Some reactions coming in, and I'm afraid to say some of those reactions are not very charitable towards Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, which is quite appalling, actually. People are questioning his credibility, calling him a stooge, and these are not fringe elements. These are leaders of the biggest parties, senior-most leaders. We'll come to that. Dr. Subramaniam Swamy, in fact, spoke. Now, let's put out that three window, because he was one of the principals in this move, along with Yogi Adityanath. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar has been leading this initiative. The principals have been facilitating it. There you can see Dr. Subramaniam Swamy, who was with Sri Sri Ravi Shankar right after these talks were held on October 6th. He visited him. They held long talks about the way forward. So this is a move that is being blessed by the Bharatiya Janata Party. And of course, there are those in the Sunni Waqf Board that are opposing this dialogue, opposing these conversations. God alone knows why. They want confrontation, they want conflict, and they obviously want to divide India. And let's be honest, the Sunni Waqf Board, the Sunnis, subscribe to a hardline view of Islam. Some of them are influenced by Wahhabi thought, which is beginning to, of course, corrode their own thinking and is based on bellicosity towards the very idea of India. So I'm not surprised, but it is dangerous. I only want to ask them that if they're leaving it to the court, I just hope they have the magnanimity to then accept the court verdict, even if the courts decide in favor of the Hindu community. Nonetheless, let's play out Dr. Subramaniam Swami's reaction, who confirmed this meeting, who talked about the way forward. And those are the pictures when he had the dialogue independently with Sri Sri Ravi Shankar.
It's a wonderful initiative on his part. And if there's anybody who can have both Muslims and Hindu parties sit together, it is him, because his whole approach is very, very secular. But a court case will continue.
Yes.
If in the meantime there's a consent order, fine. But we fully support Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. We believe he can do it.
Yeah.
But if he does it, it's a great contribution.
Yeah.
And we welcome it.
Sir, and to what levels have talks begun?
They have just started now, and he's got the Prime Minister respects him also, so the government is for it.
Yeah.
And we are all for it. We don't know, you know, Hindus and Muslims have to live in this
so
country.
You have the Congress coming on record today to say that he's a government promoted saint.
Well, they only want the Pope to negotiate.
And also, what is your viewpoint so far when it comes to the Ram Mandir issue, sir?
I'm telling you, court will win the case.
Yep.
They want the Pope to negotiate, says Dr. Subramaniam Swami. It's quite clear that they don't want the immense stature of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar to be involved, because then they will have no excuses. Listen to what some of our opposition leaders have said today. It will shock you.
Well, these are all government-sponsored initiatives. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is also like Ramdev and others who are being promoted by this government to confuse the people. They are beneficiaries of the largesse of the government, given various titles, national honors. He is responsible and his organization for destroying environment in the Yamuna the planes, and for which the NGT has taken note. Now, they have become actually collaborators in deflecting attention of the people of India from the real issues.
Okay.
And Prime Minister cannot face the people.
No.
The government cannot face.
Okay.
He had given an assurance or a promise that his government will create 2 crore jobs in a year.
Okay.
So where are those 7 crore jobs in 3.5 years? These are the fundamental questions. What about the farmers? What about the rural economy? What about the safety of our citizens? That they don't want to discuss this. What kind of a saint and what kind of initiative? Thank you.
श्री ने बोला है श्री ने राम मंदिर को लेकर बोला
है श्री
श्री श्री रविशंकर ने
कौन है कौन
सेटलमेंट करे
कौन है
कौन है
कौन है
अच्छा सर कांग्रेस का कहना है बीजेपी ने
अरे भाई ये कौन का नाम ले रहे हो
यादव सर
क्या हो गया
सर श्री रविशंकर ने कहा आउट ऑफ कोर्ट सेटलमेंट करने के लिए राम मंदिर और बाबरी मस्जिद के इशू पे और
ये जो आंदोलन ये जो आंदोलन है आउट ऑफ कोर्ट ही सेटलमेंट कर देंगे
कौन है ये कौन है ये वॉट काइंड ऑफ सेंट दिस इज आवर डिसमिसिव द ऑपोजिशन इज बींग दिस इज आवर डिसमिसिव द ऑपोजिशन इज बींग एंड वी हैव ऑफकोर्स अ पैनल हियर सम हु विल एको द सेंटिमेंट्स ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन एंड विल ट्राई टू डिस्क्रेडिट एनी मूव टू ट्राई एंड रीच ए आउट ऑफ कोर्ट कंसेंसस ड्रिवन रेजोल्यूशन गौरव भाटिया द स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द भारतीय जनता पार्टी इज वेयर विद अस Shubhrashta, political entrepreneur, is there with us. Mohammed Paracha, lawyer. Atikur Rahman, Juhi Singh of the Samajwadi Party. Arshad Alam, columnist, also there with us. I want to first begin to set this debate up by asking a very straightforward question to Mehmood Paracha. Mr. Paracha, can anyone question the credibility of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar as a mediator in the Ram Janmabhoomi talks? Can anyone dismiss him as some sort of a government-sponsored agent, a stooge? A government-sponsored guru,
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Paracha, can you hear me?
Hello? I think I lost.
No, no, you haven't lost.
I lost.
You haven't lost. You haven't lost, sir. You haven't lost. The courts will decide winning and losing. But Atiku Rehman, you may as well take that question.
Rahul, can I come in?
Yeah, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
Well, I welcome, you know, really the window opened by Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. There is no doubt about that as far as I am concerned, Rahul. But the thing is, you know, before now Sri Sri Ravi Shankar comes in, there is a widespread opposition on his name. So what I wanted was before Sri Sri, you know, put himself into this, why didn't he, you know, beforehand talk to some of these leaders?
No, which
who
leaders?
Are really opposing him.
Which leaders?
Whatever, who are the stakeholders?
No, don't be too clever by half.
Who
he
are the stakeholders?
To the stakeholders.
You know,
they have no problem.
No,
you can see the stakeholders. The list of the names
made,
of the
Rahul.
Stakeholders are also out there. No. He is speaking to the Acharya of the Nirmohi Akhara, one of the original petitioners
so
in
where
this
is he?
Case.
Take his
he is
opinion
speaking
now.
To the All
Take
India
opinion,
Muslim
Rahul.
Personal Law Board that represents the Sunni Waqf Board. Get your facts right, sir. What do you want him to do? Take permission from Sonia Gandhi.
Consensus
do you want
him
to take permission?
No,
I'm asking you. Do you want him to take permission from Sonia Gandhi? If
one
you want.
Side is going and enlightening
no, what do you
the
want?
Lamps,
you want
one leg lamps over there,
sir,
and the
I
other side
you,
is
you
demoralized.
Permission
you cannot
from Sonia Gandhi?
Have consensus in an atmosphere of hate, Rahul.
What hate, sir? This is a noble, this
Rahul,
is a noble enterprise.
Day in and
this
day
is
out,
to kill the
Muslims
hate.
Have to prove their nationality, their patriotism.
Who?
And you are saying that only on Ram
you,
Mandir
sir,
issue
to prove
you want
your patriotism
consensus.
And nationality?
It's not possible. I am sorry, it's not
have
possible,
some,
Rahul.
Have some, sir, sense. Please, let's not just oppose for the sake of opposing.
No,
here
I'm
is
not,
a man.
I'm not
no, I'm asking
that.
You something. See, you have so many, you are an Islamic scholar, sir. You have so many views. When have you tried to bring about a concerned attempt to try and settle this issue by bringing together a group of Muslim intellectuals? When have you written to the stakeholders to say, come, let's resolve this issue? Tell me, sir, what have you done?
Well, Rahul,
you've
since
only been a
1992-93, when
studios.
I was in my college days,
sir,
so
what
far,
college days? I'm
whenever
asking you, sir,
we meet, we are
instead
not
of joining
in a government,
hands,
we are not an organization, I am just a bookworm. But I should tell you, the mood of the people right now is not at all in favor of either a mandir or a masjid. You know, if you want to build consensus,
how
consensus
do you know?
Should be
excuse
only
me,
for
Mr.
peace
Atikul
and
Rehman.
Development.
Oh, no, one minute, Mr. Atikul Rehman. One second, Mr. Bhatia. One second, Mr. Atikul Rehman. Just think it through. When a man is saying, I'm trying to build consensus, obviously he's not working towards an either or situation. He's not trying to impose a zero-sum game. He's not trying to suggest that either you do it our way or you take the highway. He's trying to build consensus. He's trying to do something to bring the two communities together, and you're trying to shoot him in the foot?
Rahul, where are the confidence-building measures before the consensus?
He's trying to build the confidence.
With any of Sri Sri Ravi
what
Shankar,
better human being?
And you say
what
there
better
will be
human being, sir? The art
come
of
on, build the ground for it.
A man who goes to meet the family of Burhan Wani, a man who engages separatists. What more credible an individual?
Yes, more credibility.
What more greater humanist can there be?
He should have met all the stakeholders.
No, I think I'm getting
the
sense
media.
That Dr. Subramaniam Swami is right.
That
you actually
consensus.
Wanted to go and take the permission of the Pope.
And people
if not,
like
Sonia
Subramaniam
Gandhi.
Swami are the
problem.
Biggest hindrance, Rahul.
I have this problem because,
people
sir,
like Subramaniam
you,
Swami are
you.
The biggest
second,
hindrance.
Let me bring in, no, 1 minute. Before I bring in Mr. Bhatia, let's just listen to the other side for 30 seconds because I want to expose the thinking on the other side. Mr. Bhatia, listen to these people. Mahmood Paracha, can I ask you a question, sir, in all earnestness? Would
can
you
I,
call?
Can I come in, Rahul, now.
Yeah, let me
Rahul,
ask you the
can
question.
I come in?
Let me ask
Rahul,
you the question. Will you call the
dropped.
Imam
can
Bukhari a Congress stooge? He supported Sonia
Rahul,
Gandhi in 2014.
In?
Will you call him a Congress stooge? Answer me. Will you call Imam Bukhari a Congress stooge? Will you say, kaun hai wo? You tell me, sir, will you?
Rahul, can I come in?
Answer the question, sir. You can come in. Answer the question.
Yes, Rahul, let me first tell you the very basic thing in this.
You answer the question.
First of all, there are Gujarat elections. I can very well understand that people have to polarize the issue.
Answer the question.
I can very well understand that.
Secondly, we are first on the point of the credibility of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar as an interlocutor.
The question is, this is not a fight. This is. No, he may be a big man in his own way. Ravi Shankar Saab may be. But he is nobody in this case to intervene. Because this is not a matter of Mandir and Masjid. There is something very basic in this. This is a fight. There can be no consensus in this. Because this is a conflict between Constitution of India and criminals. This is a constitutional...
Criminals?
This
who
is a conflict
criminals?
Between judgment of the Supreme Court and criminals,
criminals
who have broken the
who
judgment and the
criminals?
Promise given to the Supreme Court.
No,
this
who
is a conflict
criminals?
Between...
Who are you
law
calling the Hindus criminals?
I'm
this asking you, are you today saying that Hindus
in India,
are criminals?
Indian
sir, take back those words. No, please take back those words because I don't want to be sucked in. No,
or
one second.
Of the Mehmood supremacy
Paracha,
of people
stop
who have
going to silence
some
you.
Kind of
no,
criminal
Mehmood,
behavior in
Mehmood,
there.
Paracha, one minute.
I would accept.
First of all,
anybody,
who are you calling?
Anybody
no,
as a
second.
Neutral person.
Mehmood
I will
Paracha.
Accept anybody as a neutral person.
Mehmood
who
Paracha,
is, first of
are
all,
you
willing
calling,
to say that
are you calling Hindus
for, I am for
criminals.
Consensus, but first of all,
Mehmood Paracha, don't
bring
shout.
In status quo ante.
Okay.
First
take
of all,
air.
Construct
Babri take him
Masjid.
Off air. Please tell him that he's come to a debate where I like to actually debate. I don't like people shouting as if they're on the streets. I would advise our guest editor to speak to this gentleman and tell him first to mind his P's and Q's and not insult another community. I'm exposing the mindsets of these people tonight. And I would like Mr. Mehmood Paracha, if he doesn't like the rules of this debate, he can leave. But he must not misbehave and not insult a whole community. Please, I would like the guest editor to speak to this gentleman, take him off air for 30 seconds, explain to him the rules of engagement of this debate. I will not stand for this hate mongering. Now, I want to bring in Arshad Alam. Arshad Alam, I want to ask you, sir, do you also share the view that Hindus are criminals, Arshad Alam? Or will you rise today and say, no, I think we need to work towards a consensus-driven approach?
No, my point is that Hindus are not criminals. I would not say that. But certainly there was a mosque which stood on the site which was demolished. And we should not forget that. This is primarily a case between a group of people who have broken the law and the Supreme Court of India. I think you, Rahul, are trying to position this debate as one between Hindus and Muslims.
Really?
Which essentially it is not.
Really?
Because when the mosque got destructed, when they demolished this mosque, lot of Hindus also condemned it. So please do not try to polarize
and
this
a lot
debate
of Muslims,
as one
sir,
between
support,
Hindus and
no,
Muslims.
And let me tell you, a lot
Number
of Muslims
two,
also support. Muslims,
with,
like the men who are sharing the stage with Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, also supporting consensus. So don't you try to turn this around and make this into a Hindu-Muslim
yes,
debate.
I mean, they are,
this is about the idea of India,
views.
And
they
let's
are,
get it straight.
They are entitled
there
to
is,
have their
no, no,
views.
No. There was a Ram temple that stood, by all accounts, and
the idea of India got demolished
no, no, no,
the
yes,
day you,
that
the Babri Masjid got demolished.
And it was demolished by Muslim
I
invaders.
Hope you get it.
The Mughals invaded,
with
they demolished
all
the mosque,
respect,
and they demolished several other mandirs across the length and breadth of this country. So let's get
I mean,
a
this is a very
no,
problematic terminology which
here.
You are using. What
let's
do you mean by out. Muslim invaders?
No. Let's open this out. I want Mr. Gaurav Bhatia to come in now. Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, you've heard some of the opening remarks.
Rahul, I would like to start by just enlightening few of my panelists, especially Mehmood Paracha ji is an advocate also. This matter is sub judice before the Honorable Supreme Court. And I don't know how he could miss out on the fact that the Honorable Allahabad High Court had favored the Nirmohi Akhada and the Hindu community, and there were traces of Archaeological Survey of India which gave a finding that there existed a Hindu temple. But being a lawyer, I would not like to persuade further because the matter has to be adjudicated by the Supreme Court of India. But I have a strong objection to the manner in which certain people like Mr. Rahmani approached this issue. They said the atmosphere in India is of hate. I ask him, the atmosphere is of brotherhood, of unity and integrity. The problem is that people like you who are pseudo-secularists, who do not even represent your own community, come out and instill fear in the community. You people question even the act where we have to honor our national anthem by standing up, that why should we do it? It is our freedom not to stand. So I would only request you and urge you, for a moment, take out this insecurity. It lies within you. It is not in the atmosphere, on the environment that we are living in. Second, I would also like to say that some panelist was talking about confidence building measure.
Yes.
Confidence building measure. Also, in Kashmir, we saw an interlocutor was appointed. I asked these people, did the separatists come out to say that, yes, we want a dialogue? Till the time there was no interlocutor, they were saying, there is no dialogue. These people don't want to talk to us. They are, using muscle power with us. And now when an interlocutor is appointed, not a single person from their communities, especially the separatists who are funded by Pakistan, came out for dialogues. This hypocrisy has to end. And All India Muslim Personal Law Board, one more example, when it came to the triple talaq issue, they did not even come out to talk about gender equality, to talk about discrimination that is meted out to Muslim
these
women.
The
and they have
majors.
All the time in the world to
yes,
contest
Mr. Bhatia,
this case of title suit
this
in
is
the
your
Supreme
attitude.
Court.
This is your
don't
attitude
shout.
Towards the community.
Don't shout.
You deviate.
Yes, in a
you
democracy,
deviate.
I
you
will respect
you bring
that
in
you disagree
Sipatala,
with me.
You bring
Please
in
don't
patriotism.
Shout. Don't spew
you bring
venom.
In Kashmir.
Okay.
Don't
you
have lost
venom.
Your ground, sir. You have
in
lost your ground.
In spite of the differences we have, you still
yes.
remain an Indian, and I respect you for that. So please don't shout.
Atikur Rahman,
we can have a debate
without shouting. We can have a debate without shouting. So let's not get carried away, because you will also end up saying nasty things like Mehmood Paracha did. And I will not tolerate that on my show. So I'm asking you very simply this, Atikur Rahman. What greater confidence building measure can there be by sending Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, an individual who has engaged not just people who are ill-disposed towards this country, but also internationally recognized as an interlocutor to hold negotiations? I want to bring in Subhrashta on this point. Subhrashta, there is a question today being asked first.
How may
of
I
all,
answer that?
1 minute, Atikur Rahman. 1 second. You had your turn, and all we've heard from you is skepticism. Let me bring in Subhrashta. We'll take a break after that. We'll come back to all of you again. Subhrashta, I want to ask you, do you think consensus is the way forward, or do you think conflict in a court is the way forward?
I think consensus is definitely a way forward, especially in a democracy which is maturing. And all this skepticism and this entire atmosphere of fear-mongering that has been fueled, I would rather say, by national political parties, by making really irresponsible statements about a person who backed a particular leader during 2014. It was not the other way around, that a particular leader approached him to back him. So I really don't know where they get their facts from. I don't know where their political narrative is. And whenever there is an issue, they want to hijack the issue by talking about all the other important issues. But I'm not saying that the issues of economy and about the general atmosphere of debate in the country is not important. It is. But you cannot hijack a concerted effort towards towards conflict resolution of an issue that has been festering for far too long. And ironically, it has been festering because it was their government in the very first place which opened the locks after they saw the egg on their face after the Shah Bano verdict. So who are they really trying to kid around with? And then we have Islamic scholars like Atikur Rahman, and I would request him to allow me to finish.
Let me finish.
You will get your chance to counter, sir.
Okay.
When they say their government, I mean the Congress government. Let me be very clear about it. And of course, you represent and resonate the sentiment about Sri Sri Ravi Shankar that Congress government did. That's why the usage of the pronoun the.
Okay.
If you really want to, get so granular in the debate. The point is, Rahul, the point is very simple.
Definitely
people like Atikur Rahman confess on national television that they are Islamic scholars who limit themselves to books.
Happened.
But, and do they do not have bearings on the ground?
Okay.
Please visit on the ground and see Muslims. Muslims are ready, willing to talk, allow them to have a voice.
Some of them are attending those talks. We take a short break.
Exactly.
When we return, we ask a bigger question. Will the Muslims, opposed to negotiation, accept any Supreme Court verdict which rules in favor of Hindus? That's the next. Stay with us. At 4:30 this afternoon, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar came out and told me here on Times Now that he was busy interlocuting between two communities to try and resolve the long-running Babri Masjid Ram Janam Bhoomi dispute. And he was trying to get the two communities to adopt a stance which would be acceptable to both parties. Very important, acceptable to both parties to agree to the construction of a Ram temple. Now, this is very, very important because he wants consensus. He doesn't want the court to decide in favor of one community or the other community. Unfortunately, there are a whole slew of individuals today who are disparaging his efforts, who are questioning his credibility and are being downright insulting. We spoke to an individual, Zafariab Jilani, just a short while back. He is, of course, the member of the AIMPLB, the All India Muslim Personal Law Board. And he came out and said to us that the Sunni Waqf Board, who he represents, will not accept Sri Sri Ravi Shankar as a mediator because he's a government stooge. Well, members of the Sunni Waqf Board are there in the picture with Sri Sri Ravi Shankar trying to work out some sort of a middle path. Let's play out that soundbite. Zafariab Jilani speaking to us.
The issue cannot be resolved through negotiation, and therefore we are waiting for the proceedings and hearing to start before the Supreme Court, for which date is also been fixed. I don't know with whom he has had talk from among the Muslim side. I don't think that any responsible person of the All India Muslim Personal Law Board has been approached by him so far. But if he approaches anyone, suitable reply will be given to him. As to what is his proposal, first that will be considered. Then only reply will be given. But so far the stand of the Personal Law Board is, and also of the Babri Masjid Action Committee, that issue cannot be resolved through negotiation, because we have several experiences of the past, and all the time we feel that the Hindu side has always tried to impress upon us that we should give up our claim, which is not possible. Muslims cannot give up their claim, and they want the adjudication of their rights, as has been done by the High Court. Now it has to be done by the Supreme Court. So there is no chance of any negotiation, I think.
Let's be clear. Had a member of the VHP or the RSS, Mr. Arshad Alam, come out and said that we will not negotiate, we will not support any move to evolve a consensus, you would have said that that individual was a Hindu fundamentalist. Was a Hindu fundamentalist who was trying to divide communities, who was not interested in building bridges between communities, who was obviously trying to impose a majoritarian sentiment upon the younger brother Muslim community. Arshad Alam, would you say the same about Zafariab Jilani today? Arshad Alam, can you hear me? Okay, I think we've lost him. Would you say the same, Mr. Atiqur Rahman?
Well, that's the point, Rahul. That's the point I was initially making, you know, and Subhash and Mr. Bhatia are taking, you know, U-turns on their...
No, will you call Zafaryab Jilani, a Muslim fundamentalist. I'm asking you a simple question. Why do you have a problem answering me? I've asked you three questions and you've danced around the subject. I'm asking you very directly. Would you say...
This is my first debate on Ram Mandir, sir. What U-turn have I taken?
Rahul, can I come in for a second, please?
Please spend more time
with books and videos. Yeah. 1 minute.
Can I make it clear, Rahul?
Atiku Rehman, will you call Zafaryab Jilani a fundamentalist who doesn't want peace between two communities? Tell me this first. Yes, no.
Rahul, they cannot be called fundamentalists. They are since the beginning, you know, working on this platform. And now a new name has come, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, which he has denied that he haven't talked to him so far. That's what
yes,
I am telling.
Before
Sri Sri Ravi Shankar came
Atiku
on the
Rehman,
media,
according to you would
where
be a neutral choice.
So many other things
name a person.
We can have a referendum on that.
Secondly, what is your objection? What is your objection to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar?
I didn't interrupt you, please.
No, I am not discussing Mr. Krishna. I am not discussing.
No, no, you discuss me. You discuss with me first the suitability of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar.
Yes, I discuss. I will discuss with you.
Tell me, ma'am, what's your problem?
That? You answer.
What's your problem? Do you agree with Sharad Yadav? Do you agree with others in the Congress party that Sri Sri Ravi Shankar doesn't enjoy
what?
The credibility to hold a dialogue?
Why should I discuss Sri Sri Ravi Shankar when the
okay.
thing is that
then let's discuss Zafaryab Jilani. Then let's discuss Zafaryab
yes,
Jilani.
Let's discuss
let me ask
him.
You.
Let's
do you believe Zafaryab Jilani is
yes,
taken
Yes, let's
a...
discuss him.
No. Let's discuss him. Let's discuss Zafaryab yeah. Jilani. You have a problem
Please.
With this? Let's take the other side. Let's ask, do you
yes.
believe that Zafaryab Jilani is taking an intolerant, hardline, Muslim fundamentalist position on this entire issue, hawkish line, which will only divide communities further?
I think
Simple.
Mr. Jilani has made this clear that he has received no proposal from
he has
the
said very clearly that this entire issue cannot
Sri
be resolved. No. Please, don't be selective.
Forget
whether he has received a proposal or not.
Please,
on principle, oppose.
One part of his argument and not the other. Please listen to the whole thing. Has any approach been made to him?
It doesn't matter. It's incidental. I'm only asking you a simple question. Juhi Singh.
Sri matters out here. Sri matters out here because you think that he's the proper person.
Miss Juhi Singh.
Our stakeholders, a point of view doesn't matter. Why is it so?
Miss Juhi Singh.
But Rahul,
Miss Juhi Singh.
A particular person fundamentally.
Miss Juhi Singh.
What is the roadmap for making him?
Miss Juhi Singh.
What is the BJP
judgment? 1 minute. Please, Atiku Rehman, don't shout over each other, please.
Let me come in. Yes.
Yeah. No, 1 second. Miss Juhi Singh, if you allow me.
You might have a problem. We have discussed talking to Rahul. Don't take my name, please. Let's discuss the issue. I'm not discussing you. I'm not discussing Gaurav Bhatia. I'm not discussing any individual. I am saying to Mr. Jilani's statement is
Rahul,
that he has not been
like
approached.
To respond to that.
Yeah, okay. 1 second.
You can respond to it.
No, Juhi Singh. Juhi Singh, can you respond
yes.
to me? I'm asking you a simple question. The
please.
Principle. The
yes.
principle. Of the discussion point tonight is whether we should go ahead with consensus or should we wait for the courts to
yes.
resolve this issue. Now, coming back to the point, the All India Muslim Personal Law Board representative is standing there in those pictures. We are not making up this picture. He's standing right next
yes.
to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Is Zafaryab Jilani's problem more because he was from the All India Muslim Personal Law Board not invited? Or is it the problem that there is a talk that is going on without his participation? Because perhaps
Rahul,
people believe that
I
he's a hawk.
I think Sri Sri is a great man of consensus. He can invite Zafaryab Jilani also. What is the issue if consensus
maybe he
has
will.
To be evolved?
Maybe
if
he
one
will.
Person
Rahul.
Is there.
But
yeah, let
other
him.
People.
We are not
will.
Against
but
that.
Juhi Singh,
let him invite all stakeholders. Who is against
down.
It?
Calm
Who
down,
is against
shout.
It? There are many stakeholders.
Don't shout, ma'am. Don't
there
shout.
There are many stakeholders. So
okay.
Let him invite everyone.
So he might. Now I'm asking you.
Rahul ji, may I
please?
Are
might.
You opposed?
Let's
1 second, Shubhrashta. 1 second. No, Juhi Singh, are you opposed to resolution through consensus? Yes, no. Simple question to you.
No, we are not opposed to resolution through consensus. We are not opposed to resolution through the Supreme Court order also. But we of course want a clear road map in which every stakeholder, and I am not saying various political parties, you might put a point a finger to me also and one to the BJP, keep aside all the political parties.
Okay.
The political parties are not stakeholders in this issue.
Exactly.
Get the people
exactly.
in.
Rahul, can I respond to Juhi ji?
Yes, please.
Yeah, Rahul, see whether it is the Congress or Samajwadi Party.
Again, it's the political parties.
Juhi, or the
then
BJP.
How do we arrive at the consensus? Or the BJP? Throw yourself in also.
What is this?
Okay,
Rahul, I think it is quite disrespectful.
One second, don't shout over each other, please. You're sitting in the same studio.
No, you did yourself. So let's not say disrespectful and try to put your point of view across better. You've spoken enough.
One second. Mr. Bhatia,
the point that I want to make, Rahul, is
yes.
Whether it is the Congress, whether it is NCP, Samajwadi Party or the National Congress, we have to understand they do not have the ideology to unite the entire country. They are all about division.
And that is of course a personal property of Mr. Gaurav Bhatia. The ideology is a personal property of Mr. Gaurav Bhatia.
This is
I'm glad he didn't throw his person
and ask. I wanted to just make a point.
You've given a chance to everyone, so I have to counter.
You know, there are issues.
I've just come back from a break.
Please complete my
I'll give you the opportunity to counter, please. 30 seconds, ma'am. Please, let's listen to him. You'll only know what to counter when you listen to the man. Yes, Mr. Bhatia, very quickly take your point.
Agreed.
Yes, I am giving you three examples where parties like the Samajwadi Party and Congress have raised these issues so that there could be divisiveness, there could be hatred amongst communities because they will pander to their minority vote bank. First is the Kashmir issue. Constitution talks about integration, but National Conference would say Kashmir kisi ke baap ka nahi hai. Samajwadi Party and Congress will talk about reservation for Muslims. It is not permissible under the Constitution. And the Ram Mandir issue again. If it was left to the minority community, I know for a fact they have a large heart to say a Ram temple should be built in Ayodhya because it's a place of prominence and it is also about the faith of all the Hindu brothers. But it is because of the politicians and the parties like Samajwadi Party that they would never want a solution to this problem.
Okay, is that true? Juhi Singh, is that true?
Whatever he... I don't want to really be disrespectful. Whatever he has said to me applies to him, Rahul, through you. I very respectfully tell Mr. Gaurav Bhatia that BJP may please control its leaders not to set deadlines and every leader of theirs, responsible ones, including their official spokesperson.
I wish there was a deadline
Mr. Siddharth Nath Singh says that they will build the temple before Arthagum. No, why should he always... That's what I'm saying. Why are they setting deadlines? If consensus is the way we are taking, if Shri Shri is the one who is negotiating with everyone. He may please call Mr. Jilani. He may please call everyone. UP wants to move forward.
Okay.
But tell him to tell Mr. Siddharth Nath Singh and his various official spokespersons not to set a deadline because you can't hold a gun to people's head
Subhrashta,
and then say
would
that
you like
we
to respond
want
to
a
that?
Consensus.
Subhrashta, would
yes,
you like
to
respond to that?
Respond
there can be
that.
No consensus if people are setting deadlines.
Rahul ji, the point is very simple. Young Indians who are watching this today know for a fact that Ram Mandir has become a bread to be baked by political parties according to their convenience. The point of the matter is very simple. All those people who have to today take a stand on consensus because that is the ethical and the right thing to do today are putting up all these restrictions of, are what if, why not? And all these clauses come because somewhere down the line the politics is getting affected. The point of the matter is the Shri Shri is a very respectful figure. He's a respected figure across the globe.
The one who destroyed Yamuna.
Madam, I did not interrupt you in between.
I will.
Please have the courtesy to listen.
I have that.
Please have the courtesy to listen and shut up right now.
Don't
the young India is
so Rahul ji, you have to ask her to shut up.
India really comes
to the problem. Don't get provoked. Calm down. Juhi Singh, please.
Rahul ji, the point is exactly that side of the political spectrum, that side of the political spectrum, which has been treating a majoritarian sentiment in this country, and has been putting it at the tip of their boots, they have a problem when young Indians articulate it the way we are articulating it today.
Boots?
And they have to address it very emphatically. She has to answer on Sharad Yadav tonight.
I will.
She has to answer
I
on Sharad Yadav tonight.
Ma'am.
And she cannot say that I will not talk on that and I will raise other issues.
No, I'm talking.
The whole
ladies,
idea of this debate right now, Ravi Shankar, is... about Rahul ji, the whole idea is that all the people who are sitting on the opposite end of the panel today will go on the defensive, start a whataboutery, and will not answer the pointed questions that you yourself
Let's bring them in one by one. Mehmood Paracha, now if you can restrain yourself to the questions I ask you, it would be helpful. And I'm asking you a very simple question.
Allow me. Let me ask you the question. I will be what I am.
Let me ask you.
I will tell you first of all, one very basic fact is, Rahul Sahab, that no community can be criminal. Communities cannot be criminals.
Good.
Criminals are individuals.
Good.
And only individuals can be criminals. Community cannot be criminal, first of all. And
good.
I never used the word Hindu.
Good.
Now coming back to my point, this is a conflict between rule of law. This is a conflict between Constitution of India and people who have broken Babri Masjid, going against the law, and they are criminals. Whoever has been having a hand in demolition of Babri Masjid is a criminal. And it is a fight between those and Constitution of India. And Constitution of India, rule of law in India is non-negotiable. Nobody can compromise on that.
Okay.
And all Indians will fight till the last drop of their blood to fight for rule of law and Constitution of India.
Okay.
That's all.
So
I have to say.
So that's why you are opposed to talks by consensus. You want the courts to decide to interpret the Constitution. Yes, Mr. Bhatia, lawyer to lawyer.
Yeah, Mehmood Bhatia ji, first of all, I think it's a title.
And Allahabad High Court is not the highest court in the country. Mr. Gaurav Bhatia Sahab,
lawyer to lawyer.
Supreme Court is, and that is what we are saying.
Lawyer to
only
lawyer.
Supreme Court will decide.
Lawyer to lawyer.
And then everybody
Mr.
will
Bhatia
have to follow.
Responding to you, Mr. Paracha, now listen to him.
Mehmood.
Now listen to him.
Allahabad High Court is not the highest court, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia. Supreme Court is.
Okay, so let now listen to Mr. Bhatia's rebuttal.
I never said so. I think I did not miss. Yes, yes, thank you. If it is about a title suit, can there be any criminal in a title suit? I thought in a title suit only title is decided. It is very nice to see that a lawyer is speaking about the Constitution. Why don't you respect the Constitution when it comes to... Please listen to me. Please, I request you. What about the Constitution of India when it comes to fundamental duty 51A, national anthem and respecting it? What about Constitution of India when it comes to Rohingya Muslims, where you were defending them and it talks about external aggression?
Now let the other man speak.
Do not
let the other man speak.
Because we will not stay on the issue.
Let Mr. Bhatia speak. I'll give you a chance. Wait. Yeah.
Yes, Rahul, my point is very simple. Mehmood Paracha, as a lawyer, cannot be selective in invoking Constitution of India. Constitution of India has to be respected. The whole Constitution has to be respected, not bits and pieces. In Rohingya Muslim, they disrespected the Constitution of India, where it is the duty of the government to ensure there is no external aggression. There are judgments of the Supreme Court, but they were siding with Rohingya. So their politics is only limited to appeasing a particular minority. It is high time a lawyer thinks like a lawyer and talks about law rather than pandering to a community.
Respond, Mr. Paracha. Respond now.
Allow me to respond now.
Are you being selective? Are you being selective in interpreting?
Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, Supreme Court is the highest court. Whether...
Absolutely.
No, not at all.
Can
whether,
you doubt
whether
that?
Whether it is a decision on title
Can you
suit
doubt that?
Or it's a decision in the criminal cases. Supreme Court, once it decided...
No, but can you doubt that?
Decides, then
don't
nobody has got
the
a say.
The title suit is
be
different
anyone,
from the
criminal
president
president
of the commission.
Tell
nobody
you
has a say
you, Mehmoodji.
So
the trial is going
Supreme
on
court,
in the trial court.
That, no one.
Nobody has been convicted
no,
so
no
far.
Two ways about
let me
it.
Tell you.
Let Supreme Court
and
decide.
There is a presumption in law that till you are pronounced guilty, you will be assumed to be innocent.
There is no presumption in law, Mr. Bhatia.
Okay.
Let Supreme
one
Court
second.
There is presumption in law.
Gentlemen, one second.
Down
the most important question. I'm going to pose the most important question to Arshad Alam now.
I don't think I can teach.
Gentlemen, one second. One second. Arshad Alam, I want to come out to you. Gentlemen, one second. Arshad Alam, it's very important. Mr. Paracha, one second. Calm him down, please. One second. Now, Arshad Alam, I'm asking you a very simple question. You have said that consensus talks is not the way out, that you will prefer a court settlement. You are entitled to that view. Atiku Rahman has also said so. You are entitled to your view. Now I'll ask you, sir, will you then take responsibility if the Supreme Court rules against the Muslim community and there is tension, violence, and non-compliance? Tell me, Mr. Arshad Alam.
No, why should I take responsibility? I can only say that all of us should abide by the Supreme Court verdict. That is it.
Well, I mean, sir, let me take you back to 1985. There was a Supreme Court verdict in the case of Shah Bano.
Yes.
And one would have thought that the Muslim community would have embraced it.
Yeah.
But what did we have? We had protests and agitations. And you did
so
not.
There so there was the a Supreme record, Court judgment on triple talaq.
One second. So
and how
no, no, no,
did
one
the Muslim
second, one
community
sir, please,
react
I'm
to
taking
that?
You back to 85. No, please.
Were
I'm taking you back to 85, sir. Please. I'm taking you back to 85.
Was the Muslim community on the street against the Supreme Court judgment?
No, no, no. 85 to 2017, 22 years passed. We cannot afford bloodletting for 22 years of this scale. So I'm asking you, am I wrong, Mr. Bhatia? Am I wrong to suggest today that in 85 the Muslim community did not respect the rule
of
law?
First of all, there was no bloodletting.
Let's ask Mr. Bhatia.
Number two.
Am I making this up, Mr. Bhatia?
The Muslims who
Rahul, you
the Muslims who opposed
hit the nail on the head.
Give me 1 minute.
Because from Shah Bano to Shaira Bano, it wasn't the Muslim community that fought for equality of the female gender. It was actually the Honorable Supreme Court that ensured dignity for the Muslim women. And I request all the panelists,
all about women
why don't they come out and fight
to
for
court,
the Muslim women
so
when it,
come
to, when it comes
it
to polygamy
really
and halala?
Going to court.
Let the Supreme Court not pass the verdict.
I thought it was
you
the Muslim women,
those
so
rights.
The women
you
alone.
Let me tell you that even after the Supreme Court struck down triple talaq, there were enough people who came out and said we will not comply. Yes, we are very grateful that moderate Muslims came out and said no.
And the Congress brought
we stand by this court, but there were many
to
who opposed. There
I
are many who opposed.
Equally
in fact,
vocally condemned that.
The Deobandis have passed a fatwa, another very regressive fatwa just a few days ago. And I don't know, sir. I don't know. The track record has been a poor one. Atiqur Rahman, will you today contest the point that the Muslim community was upset that the Supreme Court interfered in their religious personal rights? In 85?
Rahul, why you are going to 85, but?
I am going because there's precedent, sir.
Why you are going to 85?
There is precedent.
If you go to 85, then we will be going to 92.
You
will be going to 93.
Your has to be contested too.
Come on.
Okay. You're being selective now.
You are asking us.
You're being selective. I'm just reminding you of history. And history has a very bad habit of repeating itself. History has a very bad habit of repeating itself, sir. And it will be calamitous if it repeats itself in a violent way. If the Supreme Court were to rule in the favor, and I don't want to prejudice the court here or the ongoings in the court, the proceedings in the court, but I'm just saying that there will be a calamitous situation if the verdict, if it goes in the favor of Hindus, is not accepted. Think about that, ladies and gentlemen. This is an opportunity for moderates on both sides,
no,
Muslims and Hindus, to
why
rise to the occasion, support
the
Sri Sri Ravi Shankar's methodologies,
you know this,
moves
Rahul?
To build consensus.
BJP,
let's not play this game
Rahul,
of hate and contention. We'll take a short break on the news. The anthem debate gets bigger as the center takes a position and says to the Supreme Court in unambiguous terms, to the Jholawalas, in unambiguous terms, that we stand with the national anthem. Don't go away.